Okay, so 7 of the site visit and 8 have been withdrawn, so we're now moving to agenda item 9, which is on pages 55 to 62 of your packs, please. Could we have a presentation?
Thank you, Chair. Through you, Chair. This application being referred to the planning committee is a site within North Greenbelt and the proposal is considered to be a departure from the development plan. There are 15 objections to the proposed use, and these can be summarised as highway safety issues, noise, restricted access. The application for the relocation of an existing car wash within the applicant's control. The scheme comprises of a balloting structure at one end with 3 covered bays and an office waiting area at the other side. The structure will be clad in cedar. As I mentioned before, the site is within the North Greenbelt and there's no provision within the RU development plan for such a proposed use. However, the site is within an established industrial park which contains a number of industrial buildings and outdoor storage. The application site is in an area of large standing and large developed areas containing a number of large industrial buildings and outdoor storage. Paragraph 89 of the National Planning Policy Framework also states that construction of new buildings within the Greenbelt is inappropriate. However, there is an exemption which allows for the limited infilling of previously developed land, which doesn't have a greater impact on the openness of the Greenbelt. In this instance, the site contains a number of industrial type units, and hard standing is considered in this instance to be previously developed land. The footprint of the proposed building is small in scale, and in comparison to the surrounding industrial buildings, will not impact on the openness of the Greenbelt. It's therefore concluded while there is no provision within the unit development plan for such a use, the proposal is considered to be limited infilling and therefore appropriate in terms of the National Planning Policy Framework and is recommended for approval subject to the attached conditions.
Thank you. Is there a ward councillor to speak on this? No. Can I open it up to committee, please? No comments? Okay, the officer's recommendation is to approve this subject to the conditions listed. Do we have a mover?
Yes.
Thank you, David. And seconder? Thank you. All those in favour of approval? That's unanimous, that's okay. Thank you. So we're now moving on to agenda item 10, 21 Gordon's Way, which is page 63 in your packs. Could we have a presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. This application is for a new roof, wooden dorms at the front and rear, the erection of a single storey side and rear extension, and a front porch at 21 Gordon's Way. There has been a qualified petition objection received and 14 individual objections. The property is a detached bungalow located in a primary and residential area. The land rises to the east of the site, resulting in the property to the rear being approximately 2 metres above the application property, and the property to the front approximately 2 metres lower. Properties in the area are predominantly bungalows, many of which contain front dorm windows. There are examples of bungalows in the area having been redeveloped in order to raise the roof, whilst the slightly differing land levels around the area mean that there is some variety in the scale and the aims of properties in the area. The proposed alterations to see the ridge height of the property raised by about 1 metre and will incorporate 3 pitched roof doors at the front and 1 long flat roof door at the rear. It's considered that the increase in height will not be excessive when compared with neighbouring dwellings in the wider street scene. Front doors are an established feature in the area and the general design of the proposal is therefore considered to be suitable in keeping with the character of the area. As noted, the properties to the rear are set higher than the application site. A slight raising of the ridge height and the introduction of a rear dorm will be visible from these properties. However, it's not considered that this in itself will have an unacceptable adverse impact upon their communities. The proposed rear dorm windows do not serve passable rooms. The condition is therefore being attached to ensure that these windows are obscure and raised. The distance from windows on the properties at the rear to this proposed dorm will be approximately 22.5 metres to 25.8 Gordon's Way. Approximately 28 metres to 27 Gordon's Way. Given that there are no habitable windows at first floor level in the rear dormer, the required interface distance is only 14 metres, which the proposal comfortably complies with. The fact that adjacent properties are set higher than the application site will also minimise the visual impact the proposed development will have on neighbours. Additionally, there is dense vegetation to cross half the balance between 25A and the application site, and this will further minimise the visual impact of the proposed development. A single-storey extension will replace an existing detached garage to the side rear, and this will project further past the rear elevation number 19 to the side, close to a bedroom window. The rear part of this extension has been designed with a flat roof in order to minimise the impact on this window. And this, together with the slight separation between the two properties and the height of the existing boundaries, we are all considered sufficient reason to allow this part of the proposal. Importantly, there's been not been any objection from the occupier of number 19. Overall, it considers that the proposal is of a scale of design which is suitable for the area and has been designed so as to not have much or adverse impact upon the amenities of neighbours. The proposal therefore recommends for approval subject to conditions.
Thank you. Is the lead petitioner here to speak on this? Would you like to come forward, sir? There should be a button at the bottom there that you press, and if I can ask you to state your name and address, and you have 5 minutes to speak, I will let you know when you have 1 minute left.
I was speaking to Annie this afternoon, and she said that I could pass these out to the
support. What are they, sir?
Sorry?
What are they?
It's just like some notes on the greenhouse. I sent a copy of these to David Ball and I spoke to Annie this afternoon. She said they're coming out to be given today and also some photographs.
Okay, but I'm fine with the photographs, I'm just trying to clarify with Mr. Ball exactly what it is that.
I've sent a copy of this to
In terms of the letter that is referred to, what did you see that? And the actual representation and the point that the lead petitioner is making are already covered in the report and summarised in the objections. So I don't think that adds anything additional to the report. But the photographs, obviously, in which you're
at. It's just about relating to a lot of documentation, sizes, and figures, which I don't want to repeat certain ones that I told you this afternoon. I don't mind, you know.
What I've been told is everything that you've actually got within that letter is in the body of our report.
Yeah.
So we won't need to see that. Thank you very much, sir, for bringing it on. But we are happy for you to circulate the photographs if you want to do that now.
I'm calling the chair. If the general had emailed it to us, then there would be no need for the appearance of a veil of secrecy. To what apparently is a letter that you can send to Chief Officer. I'd quite like to see the letter.
Okay. I'd like to see the letter.
So that I am satisfied that the issue is in fact covered.
Okay. I'm taking the word of the officer that it's all covered within the report, but I have no objection to those letters.
No reason to doubt that.
But we'd like to see
it
ourselves.
The email, is that right?
Okay, are they going round?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. We're going to ask you, sir, to just state your name and your address, and then you have 5 minutes to speak. And I'll let you know when you have 1 minute left, okay? You've turned your microphone off. Okay.
My name is Bill Thomas, and I live at 25 A Goldsway, and it's at the rear of 21 Goldsway. I'd like to thank you for the opportunity to speak to you tonight. I'd like to point out that we're not opposed to redevelopment of properties. However, planning regulations are in place to ensure that redevelopments do not have a detrimental impact on the character of the area and lead to substantial loss of privacy and amenity to neighbouring properties. This proposed development does not comply with planning regulations HS 11, SPG 11. Well, the site plan is wrong and misleading. It does not show extensions to 25 and 27. See the Google map with the picture of them. We would openly invite any of the councillors to come along to our home. That's fine. The planning officer's report states that the application's property is 1 to 2 metres long in number 25, when actually, in fact, it's 3.45 metres long. Thus, significantly altering the number 21 metres. Segregation rule between habitable groups by using the formula in the planning guide, the distance between 25 acre Goldsway and the proposed extension should be limited at 25.575 when in fact it's only 19.8, and for 27 Goldsway it should be limited at 25.5 policy 23.60, the proposed single story large extension has fallen through those at the rear of the wall, rear wall, produce a height difference of 3 metres. This will result in considerably lower walking, 21 Goldsway, proposed large, will walk into the kitchen dining room 25A Goldsway. It also looks into the big bedroom, kitchen large at 27 Goldsway. These have two rooms of number 25 and 27, and walk straight down into the large room number 21. The balcony hedging at the rear belongs to 25A. Does not run the full length of the rear boundary. There is a gap in the hedge where the proposed single story extension will be. The report admits that the 45 degree rule between 21 and 19 is broken. It's true, there is a boundary fence between the two properties, but the proposed extension is 2 metres above the boundary fence of 1600. Because number 19, Goldsway, is set back from number 21 by some 1.2 metres, the extension will be 5 metres long. This contravenes the 45 degree rule as it was cast shadow over the roofs of the rear 19 Goldsway. Although the ridge height is the same as number 19 Goldsway, has 16 tiles roof, whereas number 21 has 14 tiles roof, thus showing the difference in ground level. Therefore, the height of the proposed single story extension will be valued to be 3.6 metres high with a projection of 5 metres and 2 metres visible breakaway, and it's only 0.5 metres from the boundary wall, clearly contravenes planning regulations explicit and affects existing light outlook and has overdominance due to the close proximity. Also, the proposed projection of the rear single story extension from the rear of number 19 at 3.8. Planning regulation states that new development should be incurring or dominant neighbours' properties. Raising the roof by 1 metre and used by 0.5 metre will make number 21 significantly higher than neighbouring dwellings on the 15th and 17th, 1923. The change of the hip to gable ends with a small thick, dug hip and large dormers back in front will result in overabundance, same post drawn and attached. Caveat number 3, mentioned in the report regarding the rear first floor windows should be obscure glazing and limited opening adds weight to our argument. The proposal is overbearing. Goldsway has 57 walkways, from 3 developments have involved roof raised height. Number 2 and number 14 backs onto the river way and not onto people's bungalows. The planning officer report suggests that the development of number 13 sets a precedent to allow the development of number 21. However, the report fails to mention that there is a segregation distance of 46 metres between neighbouring bungalows and rear. Number 23 and number 27 have refused planning to increase the main ridge height and add rear dormers. The planning officer report contradicts the previous precedent argument by stating that all the developments are just on their own rent. The report states the raising of the roof ridge has significantly changed the appearance of the hosted dwellings along the front dormers, windows, having the impact of this development. And while the street scene is mitigated significantly, that the fact that the various dwellings in the area with the wider street scene have had civil permission for extensions as well as that. This statement is incorrect.
Thank you, Mr. Thomas. I'm going to have to stop you there because your technical time is up. I think we've really got the message there about the separation. If you could turn the microphone up, that would be great. Thank you. Is the applicant or agent here that would like to speak on this? Again, if I can ask you to state your name and you have up to 5 minutes.
Thank you. I'm Edward Landor of Landor Planning Consultants Limited. Chair and members of the committee, good evening. I speak on behalf of the owners, Mr. and Mrs. Hycock, and their agent. The owners of the property commissioned the application. The location of the property is ideal as Mr. Hycock works as a surgeon locally at Harrow Park and Clatterbridge Hospital, and Mrs. Hycock is a small business owner based on Wirral, However, the existing accommodation, a two-bedroom bungalow, is no longer suited to the needs of their growing family. The proposal is to remodel and enhance the existing single-storey bungalow to create a dormer bungalow with three bedrooms in the roof space. Three small dormers are proposed on the front elevation and one large dormer at the rear. To create these bedrooms in the roof space, the height of the existing roof will be raised by less than 1 metre. The remodeled roof will be completed with half-hip gable ends. The existing detached garage is to be replaced and a new garage is to be integrated with the ground floor accommodation. At the rear of the property there will be a single-storey extension, providing a family room and utility space. A porch with glazed side panels is also proposed at the front elevation. The bungalow sits on a generous plot of 556 square metres, which means that a small increase in footprint can easily be accommodated without changing the modest proportion of the dwelling in relation to a large garden. The property will retain substantial front and rear garden space. Your planning officers have prepared a comprehensive and robust assessment of the application, currently identifying that the introduction of front dormers is contrary to UVP policy HS 11. However, the planning officers also highlighted that this policy should not be applied to this application, as dormer bungalows are a feature of Galsway. Indeed, over half, 28 of 52 properties on Galsway have dormers. Furthermore, as pointed out in that report and as illustrated on the existing street scene plan, which I don't think you've seen actually, but I have copies which I've applied to circulate, which was submitted with the application, number 21 Galsway is one of a cluster of six bungalows, of which the others all have front dormers. At present, number 21 is currently not in keeping with the street scene as the only non-dormer bungalow. Therefore, the proposed addition of dormer windows on the front elevation is in character with the street scene and will unify the appearance of this cluster of dwellings. Furthermore, the dwellings in front of 21 Galsway have dormers and hipped roofs. The planning officer's report identifies a number of examples where planning permission has been granted to alter a roof, raise the ridge height, install dormers to the front and rear, and add side and rear extensions. Your officers refer to planning approvals granted in respect of number 13, number 23, number 25, and number 27 Galsway. Indeed, the proposed application is all but identical to the alterations approved and implemented at number 13 and 14, and many other dwellings on Galsway and Teals Way. Thus, the precedent has already been established. Turning to issues of privacy and amenity, the Council's minimum standards with regard to separation distance are met and indeed exceeded. The dwellings to the south of the property are 27 metres away. Should the application be approved, there is a recommendation that the dormer windows on the rear elevation should be fitted with obscure glass and that any part of these proposed new windows less than 1.7 metres above the internal floor level shall be non-opening. The applicant has submitted the proposal with this already considered to maintain the privacy of neighbouring dwellings in line with all planning regulations. The proposed materials of construction include brick, render, concrete and roof tiles and grey UPVC windows. In the street scene, these materials are in evidence and the proposed finishes will provide a contemporary update to the existing bungalow. For all the reasons stated, we would invite you to support your office's recommendation and grant planning permission. Thank you. I do have just copies of plans which were submitted with the application, which show the street scene, which I was a bit disappointed were not included on the officer's presentation. So if your permission, I'd like to circulate those for members to see.
We can actually display the street scene.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your presentation.
Thank you.
Could I ask you to turn the microphone on, please? Yes. Thank you. I don't think we have a ward councillor to speak on this, so I'm going to open this up to committee. David?
Yes, thank you, Chair. There seem to be two issues here, as I can see it. The first one is the third paragraph on page 65 of the agenda, which in fact draws attention to the issue regarding the number of similar bungalows where a similar sort of design solution has been produced. In other words, there's a variety. variety of solutions to providing extensions in the area. And I think we should be mindful of that when we're considering this particular application. The second issue relates to the objectors' commentary, if you like. And I think we just need a clear response from the officers to whether or not the separation distances have been complied with or not. There seems to be a suggestion from them that they have not. I would like to see confirmation that they have been met before we start trying to make a decision, Chair. Thank you.
Thank you, David. Could we get some clarification on that, please?
Thank you, Chair. Yeah, just to briefly add that the street scene elevations, number 21 is here, so the top one is as existing, the bottom one as proposed. So that shows there's a number of front dormers evident, and because there's a slight difference in land levels, it's not considered that this proposal will be excessive in scale. In terms of the separation distances, so to the rear, 125A, the windows, they've got an extension on the rear, which is will be approximately 22.5 metres from the rear dormer. Now the rear dormer will also be going by, so the separation distance is required will be 14 metres. And this is 22.5 metres. Now there is a single storey rear extension that would come in 19.8 metres off the windows in 25A. Because of the difference in land levels, the 25A being set above the site, it's unlikely we'll be direct overlapping or interface distances between the two, especially if the location site is lower than the neighbouring property. So we're not convinced that there will be any loss of privacy to the neighbouring properties, basically. And I think they do comply with separation distance requirements.
Colin, if I just briefly add, these separation distances are not cast in stone. They're guidance that should be taken into account relative to the site that we're looking at. Is that true or not?
That's right, yeah, it is only guidance as well.
Thank you. Okay, another point that was mentioned was in relation to the 45 degree test. Could you just clarify those points, please?
So the 45 degree test, this relates to the cross to the side, number 19. So there is a bedroom window on the rear elevation number 19, and the single story extension is going on this boundary. It doesn't strictly comply with the 45 degree test, but it will be the 45 degree angle from the window, it should be clear. But again, that's only guidance, and we've justified on the basis that there is a fairly high boundary fence at the moment. And the fact that there's no objection from number 19, we feel that we're satisfied that it won't have a major impact on the bedroom window and that on the living room.
Okay, here
are
there's nobody else,
so, in terms of the guidance, we are saying that we fall slightly short on separation distances and that we fall short on a 45 degree issue for the lighting.
In terms of separation distances, normally those distances would only be where windows are facing directly at each other. So in this instance, you could say the first floor rear dormer that's being proposed, you could apply it to that. So we could come up for a distance of 24 metres if they were to be habitable rooms. But because the rear dormer will be not habitable and it will be obscuring lights, the distance is only 14 metres, which we require, which obviously is 22.5 metres we worked it out at, so it doesn't come to be compliant with that. The ground floor, because that's effectively set below the neighbouring property by about 2 metres, there's no direct interference between that. So that's 19.8 metres, but these don't face each other directly, because the neighbouring property is set above, so we don't think there'll be any direct loss of privacy.
I'm sorry, sir, you can't actually come back on that. Okay. The officer's recommendation is to approve. Do we have a mover for this?
Yes,
thank you. Do we have a seconder? Kathy, thank you. All those in favour, subject to the conditions listed, please raise your hands. Those against? Okay, that's carried. Thank you. Okay, agenda item 11 is a site visit, so we'll move on to agenda item 12, which is page 79 of the packet. Could we have a presentation, please?
Thank you. So this application is for a single-storey extension to an existing dwelling, with the extension to be used for small dog grooming business. Sites within the Greenbelt, and the introduction of dog grooming is a departure from the few years ago development plan. Proposed extension, together with the previous addition, will not result in more than 50% increase in floor space compared to the original building, and therefore complies with the policy GB5 extension of existing dwellings in the Greenbelt. We know the dwellings near to the site and design the proposal in keeping with the existing property, and will therefore require the policy HSMI. In terms of dog grooming proposal, the applicant has indicated that there will be no more than 3 dogs visiting the site per day, with those visits taking place between 9 a.m. and 6 p.m. Monday to Saturday. It's considered that the small-scale nature of the business is unlikely to result in a level of activity significantly above that of an ordinary domestic property. The location of the property near to the public car park at Arran Country Park provides an opportunity for linked trips, and a small number of customers likely to visit the property means that it will have minimal impact on the occupancy of Greenbelt. The application therefore recommends approval subject to the conditions attached.
Thank you. We don't have a board council here, so I'll admit it to committee. Okay, so Denise has moved approval and David has seconded it. All those in favour of approval, subject to conditions attached. Okay. Okay, we've got council meeting out of the room, so that's what we've got in favour. Okay, that's carried. Thank you very much. Okay, so 13 and 14 are site visits, so we can move to agenda item 15, pages 99 to 124. And these are planning applications decided under delegated powers between the 9th of January and the 15th of February 2018. Are we happy to know those?
Can I just ask a question, Chair?
Sterling?
On the track 9, the printed one, about the rubber club, the X, Y, and the roof, please.
We're going to have to come back to you with an answer on that one.
So I think we gave the constituents, you wanted to put the slides up on this.
Okay, I think we can get the officers to respond to you separately. Yes,
no.
In terms of everything else, we're happy to note this.
Yeah, thank you.
Ian, Kathleen, happy to note,
yeah?
Yeah. Thank you. Okay, David, are you going to provide us with an update regarding the judicial review?
Yes, the hearing was held in the courts in Manchester at the end of January. The judge has reserved his judgment and we are waiting to be notified of his decision in this case.
That is very good.